I must, for myself, examine the reasons I left the comfort of Kaldahar for a journey to Deepingdale, the place of Isalor's birth. It is much like the assignments given to me by Uncle Oswald and Isalor himself. When Isalor left those lands near the Inner Sea for the spine of the world, he told his fellow druids he would send a student to replace him. This, I told myself, was why I left. But now, as I sit by the warmth of a fire in Mirabar, I realize what Isalor must have already known. I remember the details vividly. It started many years ago. The year was 1310 Dale Reckoning, when scouts from Burn Shander, the largest of the Ten Towns, first reported sighting goblin warbands. Within weeks, a river of goblins had flowed forth from the spine of the world, and above that wave of death sailed a banner bearing the monstrous heads of the Chimera. The militiamen of the Ten Towns would have been the Dale's only defense had the forces of fate been against Burn Shander. But Albrecht Dinsmore, the mayor of the town of Targos, urged the council to send a messenger south to the port cities of Lasken and Neverwinter. Lasken had problems of her own, but fearful of repercussions, the captains of Lasken devised a simple plan. Throughout the city, they posted notices promising wealth and fame. With lean work in the northern port city, many mercenaries and thugs were lured to the ships that would take them even further north. And so their ships crept through the sea of moving ice and onto the Shaingarn River. They bragged of the deeds they would perform and the castles they would purchase. Lost in their reverie, they were blind to the throngs of goblins and orcs that lay in wait. Only a few ships survived the assault. Those that continued up the river watched as the town of Bremen burned. One of the Ten Towns had already fallen. Many wondered, as I often wonder, what difference only a few can make against so many, and in the midst of such terrible circumstances. Uncle Oswald said that Mer de Walden was full of sunsets that day. So many ships coming up the Shangarn had been set aflame by the goblin hordes that they burned to the waterline in a row like a flock of fiery geese. Some leapt overboard and tried to swim to shore, only to be cut down by orcs when they arrived. Others clung to the hulking infernos and were inevitably consumed in the flames. The rest dropped into the icy deep, snowflakes off Death's shoulders as he shrugged over the dale. So many had died already in the attacks that the failure of the Luskan forces to arrive was but a sigh, a comma in what was to be a rather long story. Only a few small ships made it through to Targos, where my uncle was watching from the upper reaches of the town. Many villagers were too busy repelling enemies at the palisade wall to notice a few sad, sorry stragglers make it into the port. The sun burned behind the horde and cast a cloak of shadows over the heart of Targos and all within. It was into this shadow that uncommon mercenaries were thrust from Captain Hedren's ship, the Wicked Wench. Like many other mercenaries in the town, these few had come from Luskan. Unlike the others, their journeys would take them far beyond the rude palisades and bloody fields that lay ahead of them.
Well, here you are, straight from Bremen to the scenic shore of Targos herself. Now that you'll be seeing the skeleton of the town you'll be defending, you sure you don't want me to take you back? Aye. You see those wrecked homes along the shore? Well, the ones the goblins didn't tear down, the people at Targos did. They're building a wall around the town, and they need all the lumber they can get. Damn wall won't keep the wind out, much less goblins, by my tell. Well, there's not much to tell. But the dock here isn't the town. Targos is up in the cliff above. Mostly decent folk, but most of them have left for Bryn Shander. Well, last word is, my ma was still living here, so mostly decent folk, aye. A regular harpy, that one. Unless you like cats, steer clear of her. And all the new mercenaries and sellswords haven't done much to help the town's color either. No offense meant. You've never met me, Ma. If you did, you'd understand. Love her to death. And that's what she'll do to you if you're not careful. Her tongue's sharp enough to chop wood, it is. Umberlee's favored daughter, me da used to say. It's where me ship got its name. Well, me da did. It's a long story. And to hear me Ma tell it, it's not half over yet. Well, I spend most of my time on the floor of the Salty Dog when I stay the night in Targos, which isn't often. With all the mercenary bands holed up in Targos, there may not be a place in town for you to rest. If the local inn can't put you up, just come back to the ship and I can spare a bunk or two for you to sleep on. Or if you want, you could probably slip into one of the abandoned warehouses to catch some shut-eye. God knows I have after a long night at the Salty Dog. It's a right enough place. There's bound to be some sellswords there who can tell you where to go and who to talk to if you're looking for a bit of gold. Might be they'll even warn you off this bit of foolishness you're on. It's just off the dock. Step a yard or two to your left and you'll be at the dog's door. Just watch your step in there. It can get a little rough. Well, you'd want to be saying the lord of this place. Albrecht's his name. Good enough fella for a lord. scale the cliffs to the main town. He's bound to be in one of the manors up there. Snag one of the locals. They can guide you better than I could. You can thank me by not following foolish orders and coming back in one piece. As guests go, you've been saints aboard my ship. I got a place for you if you ever be needing it. The town seems a mite quiet, though. And Magdar, the harbour master, hasn't come to try and bleed a few coins from me for a docking fee. Watch yourself. Could be trouble in the wind.
Well, this is somewhat beneath
me. Look who's come back aboard. Sick of Targos already, are you? Well, the ones the goblins didn't tear down, the people at Targos did. They're building a wall around the town and they need all the lumber they can get. Damn wall won't keep the wind down, much less goblins, by my tell. Well, you'd want to be seeing the lord of this place. Ulbrecht's his name. Scare the look who's come back aboard. Sick of Targos already, are you? Well now, before you be thinking I have a foolish streak myself, Lord Ulbrecht's paying me a nice lump of gold to keep the wicked wench here in port. Wants to make sure the townsfolk have a way out of Targos so things turn ugly. That's good enough for me. My ma's here, and I don't want to be seeing her come to harm.
Yeah? What'd you want? I'll handle it.
What? You know I'm your best. Something interesting, I hope. A petty task indeed.
Yes. It shall be done.
What? Taken care of.
What is it you require? As you wish.
Here I come. And there's no escape!
Fine. Just of course. But what exactly do I get out of this? Won't be a problem.
Yes. Consider it done.
This better be good.
Yeah. Fine.
What?
At your service.
Huh?
What'd you need?
What is it?
What? You know I'm your best. I guess.
Ready.
I'm always ready. Something interesting, I hope. Fine. A petty task indeed. Better be good. Of course. Lover.
I will slay you.
You cannot win.
Boys, you better stand aside and let this woman get down to business.
You cannot win.
What? You know I'm your best. This won't be a problem. I'm always something interesting, I hope. Fine. Just a petty task indeed. Don't stand against me.
I'm going to enjoy this.
I'll teach you milksops how to fight!
You are powerless against me.
Victory will be ours!
This better be good.
I am indomitable!
Boys, you better stand aside and let this woman get down to business. This won't be a problem.
Thank you.
I guess.
What can I do?
What? You know I'm your best. Of course, lover. you'll die my way.
Death to the enemy.
Thank you.
Now, this is somewhat beneath me.
Okay.
Of course, lover.
I'm ready.
What is it?
I am ready.
Can I help?
I'm on my way.
I'm always ready.
Tell me what to do.
Your death is at hand.
I will slay.
Come then, let us begin.
I'm listening. All right. Yes, all right.
I'm going to enjoy this. You are powerless against me.
Consider it done.
Something interesting, I hope.
You have my attention.
What do you have in mind?
Meow.
I'm listening. So be it.
Fine. Just please tell me this isn't going to take long. Of course. Lover. Ugh. This is somewhat beneath me.
Oi!
What is it?
Mm-hmm. Sounds good. Yeah. Sure.
This better be good. This is somewhat beneath me. Of course, lover.
Thank you.
Of course. But what exactly do I get out of this?
Thank you.
Good.
What? I guess. Of course. But what exactly do I get out of this? Well, this is somewhat beneath me. This won't be a problem. This is somewhat beneath me. Of course, lover. Of course. Lover. Well, this is somewhat beneath me. Of course. Lover. I guess.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
What? Of course, lover. Of course, lover. You know I'm your best. I'm always ready. Of course. But what exactly do I get out of this? Something interesting, I hope.
Apologies. I didn't see you standing there. What can I do for you? Or was there something I was supposed to do for you? Introductions, of course, introductions. Sometimes the ideas will start rattling around in my head, and I'll wake up to find I'm somewhere else, or talking to someone else. My name's Fiddlebender. Oswald, that is. Well, Fiddlebender's my last name. My first name is Oswald, so it's Oswald Fiddlebender. A pleasure to meet you. Ship? Oh, you mean this one here? You mean my airship? Yes, yes, indeed, it's mine. Beautiful, isn't it? Didn't know which ship you meant at first, for there are many common ships about, but this one is quite extraordinary. Most ships travel upon the water. This one, however, travels upon the air. Indeed it does. It was wondrous. Well, before it crashed in Targos, I flew it all the way from Kuldahar, you know. Why, I live in Kuldahar with my niece, Marilee. I mean, well, I set up shop there after I landed in town. Well, crashed maybe, but that's neither here nor there. There's an awful lot of mountains around Kuldahar. Very confusing to fly through, or around. It's hard to steer the ship when I'm in the lab, I discovered. Didn't I tell you? I must have. Why, I make potions. I mean, well, among other things, I'm an inventor. I make things. And potions. Did I say that? Ah, welcome back. Something I can help you with? A potion to put some color in your cheeks, perhaps? Ship? Oh, you mean this one here? You mean my airship? Yet most ships travel upon the water. This one, however, travels upon the air. Indeed it does. It was wondrous. Well, before it crashed in Targos, I flew it all the way from Kuldahar, you know. Oh yes, the damage there. Well, the landing here in Targos was somewhat bumpy, and it took some time to put out the flames and mend the wooden frame. And of course, there were all those potions that shattered in the crash and caused those nasty fires on the northern side of town. Fortunately, all the residents had already fled at my approach, so it was only a matter of time before the flames died down and we could approach the ship. Quite a mess, but we got it all sorted out. Oh, well, now that's another story. Had to fashion a spell of my own to mend the ship. Oswald's Mending, I call it. Quite catchy, I think. Getting the components for it can be quite exhausting, let alone remembering them. Wrote it all down in a book in the lab. Let's see. There's spider silk. Fresh spider silk, mind you. Not old. Belladonna paste, crushed diamonds, some thrim extract, a little bit of iron ore, some wood, of course, unless you crashed on a house or near a big tree, in which case that isn't a problem, and, well, can't remember the last bits, but I have it all written down. Very true, very true. Can't see this airship crashing anytime in the near future. Sturdy as a rock. Well, of course they can. Just get a giant to throw them, and even the largest stone will fly like a bird. A very heavy bird, mind you, and no wings, but the principle is the same. Didn't I tell you? But I must have. Why, I make potions. I mean, well, among other things, I'm an inventor. I make things. And potions. Did I say that? Not often. Very dangerous, some of them. Others are volatile. Some are both. Of course. Well, no, I mean, I'm part of the Targos Guard. A scout, you see. An aerial scout. A lot of goblins, mostly. Those goblins shoot a lot of arrows, you know. I've told them to stop it on many occasions, but they only seem to understand after I dump several casks of flaming oil on them. Well, everywhere. Quite a mob of them. Obrek, he's the lord of the town, you know, has asked me to look for large concentrations of them and report back, which I am more than happy to do. Helps pay for the damage to the town when my airship landed. Welcome back. Something I can help you with, ship? Oh, You mean this one here? You mean my airship? Most ships travel upon the water. Indeed it does. It was wondrous. Well, before it crashed. Why, I live in Kaldahar. There's an awful lot of mountains around Kaldahar. Very confusing to fly through. Or around. It's hard to steer the ship when I'm in the lab, I've discovered. Oh, yes. Merrily. Quite the fiddlebender as fiddlebenders go. She's growing like a quick weed. She's almost up to my knee.
Yeah. Okay.
Fine. Of course. Lover. Of course. Lover. Of course. But what exactly do I get out of this? Of course. Lover. I guess.
Sounds good.
This better be good. What? This is somewhat beneath me.
Ready. Good.
You know, this is somewhat beneath me.
What? I'll do it.
I'm always. Something interesting, I hope. Of course. Lover.
Can I help?
Sure.